The 10 former Umkhonto we Sizwe parliamentarians have suffered a setback in their attempt to be reinstated in the National Assembly after losing a High Court bid on Monday. Judge Kate Savage dismissed the group's application for an urgent interdict, ruling that they had failed to demonstrate a prima facie right to be returned to Parliament. The ruling also ordered the applicants to pay the legal cost. The disgruntled group had approached the court last week, arguing that they had left their previous jobs to serve as members of parliament. They contended that their removal by the party's leadership was illegitimate and without proper grounds. However, Judge Savage found that the applicants had not proven a reasonable apprehension of irreparable harm if they were not reinstated immediately. Furthermore, the court determined that the former members of parliament had other legal avenues available to them, negating the need for an urgent interdict. The case stems from the dismissal of 18 former MK members in July, a move that also cost them their positions in parliament. Despite their legal challenge, the court's decision now leaves them with limited options to regain their parliamentary seats, pending further review of their dismissal by the party. The Umkhonto we Sizwe party has released a statement welcoming the judgment, and the media statement reads as follows. Statement on the dismissed court application by the 10 recalcitrant litigants. The Umkhonto we Sizwe party welcomes the judgment handed down by the Western Cape Division of the High Court regarding the court application by former members of parliament, which is dismissed with cost. The Umkhonto we Sizwe party never intended for this internal matter to enter the public arena, as the discharged members were formally informed not to proceed to be sworn in as members of parliament. They proceeded with the swearing in and were subsequently informed by the party that their presence in parliament would be temporary. It was not enough for these recalcitrant litigants to drag the party to court, which led the party to incur unnecessary costs relating to the changing of office logs, keys, and even hotel accommodation for new members who could not access accommodation in parliamentary villages. The MK party was further negatively impacted in parliament in voting numbers due to these acts of ill discipline by these perfidious individuals. The court's punitive order only reaffirms our initial position that this matter should have been dealt and dispensed with internally, as this has brought the organization into disrepute. All due procedures was followed in expediting the matter, and we have been vindicated. The courts cannot be subjected to frivolous applications by wounded party members who fail to not only comprehend but also adhere to the party line. The continued egregious efforts of individuals who place their personal agendas ahead of the organization and the revolution will be thoroughly met with decisive action, as no one is bigger than the organization. We, as the Umkhonto we Sizwe party, continue to work towards our mission to hold the executive accountable as the official opposition in parliament and work to implement the people's mandate. We shall continue to lead and unify all black parties of the Progressive Caucus under the Common Fundamental Principles and Minimal Program of Action to ensure the true liberation of our people. What's your take on this one, people? Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more news.